name's Patrick Duffy from Red 5. Patrick, good to meet you. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Andrew, and thanks for giving us the opportunity to come on your show.
Give us an introduction here, Patrick. Tell us a bit about Red 5 and the King of the Hills project.
Yeah, absolutely. So Red 5 does have three mining assets, two in Australia, one in the Philippines called Siena. But our flagship project is the King of the Hills, which is currently under construction. And I'd be more than happy to walk you through that today.
Well, indeed, you say a milestone here for the project recently, 50% completion. So bring us up to date. Tell us a bit about it.
Yeah, so the project has a price tag of $226 million. It's been constructed by Macca Interquip, a Western Australian engineering firm. It's, as you said, just passed its 50% project completion milestone, well on track for first gold in the June quarter of 2022, which is not too far away. Despite the labour market challenges in Western Australia, the project remains both on schedule and within budget, and all of the major contracts are committed and all the fixed price contracts. Therefore, we are very confident we have the protection against the sort of cost inflation that we're seeing in the industry.
And you're sitting on is it a 2.4 million ounce ore reserve there?
No, exactly. So we're very fortunate to have such a huge ore body. So 2.4 million ounces of ore reserves, which puts King of the Hills in the top 10 gold mines in Australia. And that we're very confident we'll be mining for at least the next 16 years. So when it starts, the mine will be well below the industry average cost curve, and we expect it to be producing well over 200,000 ounces per annum. And maybe I can just add, we are installing a highly efficient processing plant at King of the Hills with a SAG mill of similar dimensions to Evolution's Lake Cow gold mine and also Gold Road's Gruyere mine, which, like King of the Hills, both of these large mines are also in the top 10 gold mines in Australia.
I see, Patrick, you're planning to transition the Dalit mine into an additional feed source for King of the Hills here.
That's right. So maybe just a step back, Red 5 purchased Darlow and King of the Hills back in 2017 and has been relying on production from the processing plant at Darlow. Darlow is an aging gold mine that has been mined successfully for over 33 years. But importantly, we've announced the intention next year to start tracking the ore from Darlow and it becoming a satellite mine to King of the Hills once the King of the Hills mill is into production. But the exciting aspect of this model is that we expect to save over $300 per ounce at Darlow as a result of the lower processing costs and anticipate Darlow now being a high-grade satellite feed to King of the Hills for a number of years. Maybe if I can just also add, in the current year, we'll be using the Darlow processing plant and be treating ore from the Darlow underground mine and at a nearby satellite mine called Great Western. So our guidance for FY22 is 62 to 72,000 ounces, Andrew.
I see you mentioned, Patrick, right at the start about your asset in the Philippines. What are the plans for this?
Yeah. No, that's right. So Red 5 does have its legacy in the Philippines, which it built the Siena gold mine a number of years ago and operated it, but it has been in care and maintenance. But we are very pleased to announce a $55 million divestment of Siena. Two important aspects of this transaction. First of all, we'll receive an upfront cash payment of US $19 million this quarter once the financial close is completed. But also the buyer is TVI Resources, which is a joint venture with one of the major Filipino families and who has the influence and the funding to get Siena back into production, and they're experienced miners. So this is important. We'll also receive a US $35 million royalty stream once it's back into production. But great to have this transaction announced to the market and really allows Red 5 to push ahead through this exciting development period at King of the Hills, where we anticipate having at least $60 to $70 million of cash in our bank at the end of September, which will give us a really strong balance sheet to support the development of King of the Hills.
And just crunching a couple of numbers here, with an EV to reserve of around $150 an ounce, how does Red 5 stack up against other miners on the ASX?
Look, if I can be modest, I think it's one of the biggest growth stories, upside stories in the ASX right now. So if you put this into perspective, I mentioned Gold Road before about its Gruyere mine, which has in the past 2 years been ramping up to full production and very successful. But Gold Road has an EV to reserve of $600 per ounce as compared to Red 5's $150 per ounce. So we do anticipate, as we approach first production in the next couple of quarters, that the discount in our share price will reduce significantly. And consistent with the share price performance of other recent new mines, we expect a lot of growth coming up.
Just a final word then, Patrick, this morning, in the lead up to first gold pour here, what are those near-term milestones we should be looking out for from you?
Moving forward, a very clean story for Red 5. So construction progress, steel erection, and then installing the mill and the crusher. McMahon's will be mobilizing at the end of this year and starting to mine. And we'll also be putting out underground drilling results from King of the Hills. Maybe, Andrew, if I can do a final plug, anyone that's interested in further updates, encourage you to subscribe to our news via the Red 5 website. And also to follow our LinkedIn web page, which has weekly videos of construction progress at King of the Hills.
Very good. Patrick, good to meet you. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, thanks very much, Andrew.